I'm here with boxing star John Molina Jr. John, there's so much going on in the world. First of all, how you feeling today?
Good. Another hard day at work, as you can tell. You get to see it firsthand, working our butt off.
Man, this is the fastest I've ever seen you, the hardest I've ever seen you. You're just so pumped up right now. You're motivated.
You have to be. You have to get up for a fight like this. I mean, Adrien Broner's he's a real deal, man. He's a tough nut to crack, so we're going to have to go.
Hey, I think he's one of the most talented fighters in the world.
He is. He definitely is.
Three-time world champion, the youngest to ever achieve it, I think.
Look, like I said, as much as people don't like him because of his outside-the-ring antics, you got to give him credit where credit's due, and then our job is to go upset that apple cart on March 7th.
I don't mind that. Listen, I like his personality. It's good for a sport when someone has personality. Imagine if everyone you interviewed would just give you yes, no answer.
Yes. No. Let's get.
Okay, so some
I'm
of the big stories.
So I don't get
some
fine.
Of the big stories on the news.
I'm only here so I don't get fined.
Yeah, and then he didn't get the ball in there. Did he say that? That's why they didn't pass
the
ball.
I don't think they should have given him that damn man. He would have. That's one of their
comments. Okay. The big story in the sports world today, and I'm very surprised. Anderson Silva failing 2 tests for sports enhancement steroids.
Yeah, it's unfortunate.
It's a shocker.
A great athlete. A great athlete in the sport of MMA, and it's just a shame that he, had to go out like that. I think they both failed tests.
But Nick Diaz failed for smoking weed. I don't smoke weed. I never smoked weed, but that doesn't make you... This is a combat sport, John. It's not tennis.
If anything, that's debilitating towards himself.
It makes you less aggressive, I think.
Yeah. So.
But it's what he does, but... Have you ever seen a fight where both main event guys failed different tests? That's pretty rare.
This is my first time seeing it. It's unfortunate because a lot of kids look up to these guys, you know, role models and whatnot. So it's unfortunate that they do get popped like that. You know, sometimes we gotta not think about ourselves and think about the kids that are looking up to us.
You're right. But not only that, but when you're a fighter, you have a trainer, you have a team, you have a family, you have other fighters that want to be where you are, that would kill to be in that position to fight and headline and make money. And that kind of like takes away. Besides that, whether it happens in boxing or MMA, it hurts the brand.
It does hurt the brand. You're right. You're right in every word that you just said. It's
putting in that work.
Yeah, it's unfortunate, but you know, especially you always want a competitive edge, but you don't want to cheat to get that competitive edge. You got to push the envelope. You got to have the right team behind you that's going to make sure everything that's going in your body is on the up and up. And the competitive edge, I'm okay with that. But when you get into the realm of cheating, it's not a good thing for the sport.
You heard what Lance Armstrong said last week?
No, what did he say?
They asked him, would you cheat again? He said, absolutely yes. No regrets. Like, I would cheat again and I would do it again.
That's probably because he lost all his sponsorship already.
But he denied. For years, he said he never did anything.
Look, like I said, I'm all a fan of being competitive in everything you do. But when you get into the realm of cheating, then that's not right. But you got to remember, that's why they have a commission that governs this so strictly. Believe it or not, the commission does govern it. They do a lot of tests. They have physical tests. They have tests where the commission has to physically see you, give you a specimen. Yeah.
They do. I know fighters who didn't pass because they asked them how much is 69 minus 5 and they couldn't answer.
Well, there's the mental test, the motor skills. There's a lot of, there's like a mathematical equation. It sucks, but you learn to deal with it. They make sure you can still, the hamster's still running on the wheel. Take a step.